I was being a little bit cheeky here, letting a gap open up to those guys, and then trying to kick as hard as I could to close it on my own. The guys up front, they weren't having it, and the guys behind weren't having it either.
We're at the Winchester Park and Ride, which used to be a staple of my early racing career. I haven't actually raced it for a good 3 years now, or 2.5 years since I was a third cat actually, so it's fun to race here. Basically, a sausage circuit where one of the ends is a hairpin into a slight rise, so like 2%, maybe 3%, and then yeah, you just turn back and then go back down again and repeat. Basically, it's very similar to a 30-30 interval session. So yeah, it's fun. Feels going to be interesting. There's not a huge field, but there's two guys from Canyon, so that'll make things very interesting. So the race is just over an hour plus three laps, I think, so that'll be good fun.
So I started off the race pretty aggressively. I was with the mindset that I wanted to, you know, bring the rate of the Canyon guys and start attacking, because once they start 1-2ing me, that's just gonna just put me into the ground. So I was like, if I can try and get off the front and one, or worst case both of them join me, then at least that's a bit better. So yeah, putting quite a few digs early on, a lot of digs. I was digging myself in a bit of hole. Look at the disappointment on my face here when I realise that Alex Payton is basically on my wheel after I put in a pretty big dig. So that was a bit annoying, but yeah, put in a few digs. This is the sort of less technical side of the course. Obviously here, one of the other Canyon guys attacked and I have to respond, because the group just looks at me like, you're the other Continental rider. So that's how that race sort of had to happen. Yeah, this is the less technical side of the course, so two sort of 90 degrees. You can take these basically full speed. It's not too bad, but it is fairly easy for small gaps to open up there, just because not everyone wants to take it full speed. So here's another attack from the Canyon guys. I looked, I saw him, and I saw no one was going with it, so like, crap, I have to go, have to join onto this, because that was going. So yeah, this is the hairpin, the really sharp corner. Coming through this is where most of the attacks, people make attacks, because it's like ever so slightly hilly, so it's like 2 or 3%. And this is, yeah, I think we've probably made an attack through here a couple times. And yeah, so again, I was just trying to bring the race and race aggressively as possible. Unfortunately, at one point, Alex Payton, he got a gap. I couldn't close it down. I think I tried to bridge across, but couldn't, because I couldn't get a gap. And then after that, I got countered by the other Canyon guy, and that was that. And both of them got in a two up, and yeah, that was pretty tough. I saw this, the guy on the white attacked. I was gonna go with it, and then I thought, I don't wanna bring the whole bunch, so you have to try and make a good time to bridge across instead of reacting straight away all the time. So at this point it's mid-race, the guys had a good half-lap gap, so the pressure was off a little bit, so we weren't really going quite as full gas. I did put in a few attacks to try and a few digs to get away, but after going pretty deep in the first 20 minutes, I didn't quite have the snap that I would have liked to be able to establish a gap or even bridge across. So yes, yeah, another time, it's from the back side of the circuit, it's just trying to get a gap, and it's another one here, just a small gap, but just not really big enough to actually establish anything. And another one, it's like this is just after obviously that slight uphill home straight, so that's where all the gaps open up, and then they sort of close down here, unless you're really pushing on the pedals. So at this point, the Canyon guys had nearly lapped us. It's about a minute lap. They nearly lapped us. Like, we pretty much resigned to the fact that that was going to happen. It didn't really make a difference. Once they sort of caught us, it kind of neutralised our bunch. And I won't lie, I was being a little bit cheeky here. I was sort of letting a gap open up for those guys, and then trying to kick as hard as I could to close it on my own, and you know, obviously get a gap to the rest of the bunch. But the guys up front, they weren't having it, and the guys behind weren't having it either, so can't really complain that that wasn't working. So eventually we let those guys go again, because, you know, it's basically, they're irrelevant to us, they've already got secured first and second. And we basically did quite a lot of noodling around. There was a few tacks here and there, but we were, there was obviously no reason for us to, there's no reason for anyone to be on the front, so it's like three laps to go, and we were basically just completely club run five abreast or whatever it is. So here is coming up to one lap to go. Obviously the Canyon guys are a lap up, so you'll see in a minute they're behind and they're going to sprint for the win. But I'm here on the right of the road looking, because I know someone's going to go for a flyer here, because it's a popular move for the guys who don't fancy the sprint. And yeah, Paddy Rounds go for attack. And behind, the Canyon guys finish with Jacob Hennessy winning.
He had almost every possession recently.
Kobe! Sprint finish. And yeah, not much to add to it. Felt pretty good in the sprint. Got a bit loose at the end, to put it as one word. Because obviously it starts off a lot slower, so you have to pick a good gear. You don't want to change gear too much. So I rode down to the race, and now I'm gonna do a bit of an extra loop and notch it up to 5 hour ride. So that's gonna be fun. Play the let's keep the average speed really high game, because obviously the race makes you high in the first place. So that's always a fun way to get out a bit of zone 2 and zone 3, so do a little bit of that, and yeah, do a 5 hour ride, so that'll be fun. The weather's actually, it's alright, it's sunny, and yeah, can't really complain. Anyway, that's going to be the end of the video. Give it a like and subscribe, and thanks for watching.